gentlemen. Welcome to the Griswold School Spring Concert. Let's give our students and Ms. Wilson a big round of applause for her. We're very excited for our dance band, our jazz band, and our beginning band tonight to play you some tunes they've been practicing for a long time. And we're very excited to be back in the cafeteria, just like old times, hosting our show. A couple reminders, after each group is done, there will be an opportunity for you to take pictures. So please keep that in mind while they're performing, that when they're done playing, there's a chance to take pictures. If you need to use a restroom, there are two restrooms right outside the hallway right here. And I hope you enjoy the show. Here comes Ms. Wilson.
The Star-Spangled Banner by Francis Scott Key. The words of our national anthem came from a poem called Defense of Fort McHenry, written in 1814 by Francis Scott Key. You wrote this poem after you witnessed the Battle of Fort McHenry during the War of 1812. The poem was set to a popular rhythm song written by John Stafford Smith. It became a national anthem in the United States in 1931 when President Herbert Hoover went to Congress. This is a great arrangement by Mark Williams. Listen for the flutes and the clarinets to play an interesting highline in the second section of the song along with the fanfare from the trumpets. This coming Saturday night, the advanced band will have a great honor of performing the Star Spangled Banner at the start of the Britain meeting for Griswold School Night. We hope to see you there. Please rise for the performance of our national anthem in the United States of America.
Thank you. by William Owens was composed in 2016. Tornadoes can be very dangerous and violent. Some people have a hobby of tracking severe weather in hope that in case that they catch one of these dangerous storms. This piece offers a musical glimpse of the most unusual hobby. Listen for the raindrops and notice to be heard as the storm approaches. The music built in is on the speed and the volume increased. You will hear the tornado sound warning people to get to shelter. This is a familiar sound if you live in the Midwest area called United States Tornado Alley. In the middle of the piece, the music briefly and clearly becomes calm as the storm may do. The music slowly brings us into the heart of Chase before driving to the sudden and abrupt conclusion. We hope you enjoy this one as much as we do.
Behind the scenes fixing instruments and doing things I don't even know that's happening, you know, while we're tuning and helping tune. So thank you so much for all the help back there. So let's give them one more round of applause. And now it's time to welcome the percussion can come on out and grab an instrument or something. Percussion parents can come up, take a quick picture. Flute parents, flutes all stand up please in the front row. If you would like to come and get a close-up of your child, please feel free to come up quickly. On deck will be the clarinet parents. And behind them, the saxophone here, can get behind them. And a few of the trumpets behind them. All right, percussion, you may exit. I encourage you to stay. Our performance is not long. And I encourage you to stay for our jazz band and our beginning band. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised at how amazing they sound as well. So please stay. And it's great for them to have a huge audience too. Flutes, you may go. Second row, please stand up, please. Clarinets in the second row. Swing style jazz for you. Usually the The jazz ensemble is made up of saxes, trumpets, trombones, and the rhythm section over here. But we think jazz is for everybody. I'm an oboe player, so I always felt slighted that they wouldn't let me in the jazz band. So flutes, trombones, and baritones, clarinets, we don't care. As long as you can swing, you can come and be in our jazz band. The first thing that they learned was the jazz blues scale. And this blues scale is obviously for jazz blues music, but it's also the same scale that you would hear for a lot of the rock tunes, like Smoke on the Water. Basically, the first three notes of this would be the same as a lot of your favorite classic rock tunes. So without further ado, we're going to demonstrate the scale for you and the process of learning how to improvise. So they learned this scale, and then they learned little rhythmic patterns, almost like vocabulary words, to apply that to the scale. And then we'll demonstrate that for you. And then they took these rhythm patterns and they used the notes of the scale to start making little tiny improvisations, meaning making it up as they're going. So they have certain notes they can use, certain rhythms they can use to make it swing, but then they're making this up on the spot. So they're going to demonstrate their improvisation skills for you, and then we'll apply that to some of our music, two pieces of jazz music for you.
Don't
hit
phone.
We have Elena on trumpet in the back,
And we have Emma and Clara in the front, so be listening for them in the middle.
Thank you.
picture, front row stand, stay standing. Front row can come up, parents come up for a picture. That's clarinets and saxes and guitars. Percussion, you guys can come up for a picture if you'd like. Second row, you can stand. Trombones, baritones, and flutes, stand. And parents can come up for a quick picture. Front row, you may exit. Here is our beginning band, made up of fourth graders. Just less than a year ago, less than 10 months ago, they didn't know what instrument they were going to play, and they were thinking about which one they wanted to play and making their choices like our current third graders are doing. Today, the third graders came to the concert and they had a demo. So if you have if you're a parent of a third grader, you had homework actually from this program. You have some homework. So the kids will tell you about your homework, parents of third graders. Here's mine to tell you about our first piece.
Thank you.
creatures in the attic. I have a secret that I'll no longer keep, explaining lots of little sounds when everyone's asleep. Is that when I get outside or knocking on the door, they may just be my fuzzy friends making noise between each snore. They start up very quietly, when all the lights go out, they check to make sure no one's watching, then they start to dance about. Pretty soon they're going crazy, a midnight celebration. I'm glad they're having fun, but where's my invitation? As soon as dawn approaches, they start to settle down. Putting their toys away, they cease to make a sound. And then we wake up wondering, was that TV static or freaking? Others may wonder, but now you know, it's just creatures in the attic.
Thank you.
traffic policeman sends up images of a master craftsman posing the pose of Soldado Battle. The dramatic music portrays the intensity and the relentless pounding as the magnificent place slowly begins to take shape. The ancient Gregorian chant referenced to Diaz Vivae helps convey the image of glowing metal which resembles molten lava. Listen for the sound of the pounding of the metal played by hitting from a real big chill from a car. We hope you have enjoyed our performance. Thank you for welcoming.
Really hard. Thank you for keeping on them about the practicing, about the practice charts, and you know, reminding them to bring their instruments. Thank you for dealing with all my emails, because I send a lot of them at 11 o'clock at night, so hopefully your phones are off. So thank you to the custodians who set this all up and break this all down. Thank you to Mr. Nick Smith and all of his tech guys, and we have some great guys in the back here. Some former Griswold School students who are head of technology over at the high school doing a fabulous job. Thank you for coming to live stream our concert. It will be available, both concerts today will be available on VHS TV, on YouTube, on their YouTube channel, so you can share it with friends and family who weren't able to be here. Again, the fourth and fifth grade teachers, I can't say enough.
Thank you to Mr. Kisman and Mrs. Quinn for your support and help whenever I need something. I don't know if you have seen the new band wall here, which is just right on the other side of this wall. Feel free to walk through and see it. Thank you as taxpayers. Thank you to Board of Ed members for allowing us to have this beautiful band. Our shelves and cubby holes have just been installed in there this past week, and they look great, so you can take a walk through the band room on your way out tonight and check it out. Mrs. Fazina, who's not here tonight, but she's my other colleague here, this is an effort that we start in kindergarten and we cultivate all the way up through fifth grade, and then we hand them off to our middle school teacher. The fifth graders are all yours. And we hand them off to Mrs. Terlecki over at the middle school, and for them to continue their musical growth. So I thank Mrs. Fazina as well for her musical support. Obviously, thanking the Board of Ed earlier with Mr. Benigni as well as our superintendent. He's always so supportive of whatever we need, you know, through all the crazy COVID stuff. It's like, we need, you know, instrument bell covers. We need this, we need that. Okay, no problem. We'll get you what you need. So thank you for your support. Obviously, so many people behind the scenes during the school day, Mrs. Rockford and Mrs. Zub, answering the phones, answering your phone calls, answering emails, you know, helping, you know, give instruments to kids who forgot them. So they're amazing. All of our BCSAs and our parents that are behind the scenes copying programs for us. I also wanted to mention that if you have not signed your child up for the Anthony and Joseph Andy Band Camp, it is a two-week camp. It is amazingly great for their musical development. They get to work, it's grades five, so entering grades five through nine. So if you have the time in your schedule to let your children go and sign them up, it's a pretty cheap camp comparatively. It's a two-week half day mornings. And there's a flyer at the door, and I've emailed it home as well. If you still need information, please let me know. Even if your child can only go for 1 week, it's worth it. And they have a lot of fun and make a lot of new friends, especially our fifth graders going into sixth grade. They'll make some friends from middle school, so there'll be a little bit easier transition getting over to the middle school. So I encourage you to sign up for the band camp. Again, Ms. Nordette, thank you so much for your help with that jazz band. We couldn't do it without you. And I think that's it. And if I've forgotten, oh, I know. So the programs that you see tonight, we've had many students submit some of the covers to me. We have some great artists here as well as musicians at Crescent School. And it was difficult to choose, but I chose like six of them to be on the front cover. So congratulations to the winners and to the people didn't win. You guys did some great artwork too, and we just can't do all of them, but fabulous job on the artwork, fabulous job for my speakers, and I think without further ado, we should have pictures, right? So if you have your percussion parent or a flute and clarinet parent, come on up, and if you have a student in the front row, please stand. If you are finished and you need to find your child is going to be in the gym. In the auditorium slash gym in the middle of the school. You can go and find them there and wait right outside. They can come out and find the gym.